with our physics today. Already we have started about Earth and solar system. We are only focusing on Earth. Am I right? We are focusing on the first Earth. Let's learn in detail about that Earth. In the last period, we have discussed about why the Earth is called as a unique planet, and also we have discussed about why there is a life exists on Earth. Why does life exists on Earth? Yes, because of the atmosphere. Also, we have discussed the different layer of our atmosphere. We have also discussed about this point, axis, equator, rotation, revolution. So see students, axis, so I will show you the, see this is a globe, am I right? So suppose this is an Earth. The axis is nothing but an imaginary line. It is an imaginary line which starts from the center of the Earth, from here, from the center of the Earth till the, from North Pole to the South Pole. Are you getting? So this is called as an axis. That is called as an axis. Are you getting? Then equator. Can you see this line? Can you see this middle line? So that is nothing but an equator. Equator is a line which divides the Earth into the two equal parts. That is the line which divides, the equator is a line which divides the into the two half part. That is northern hemisphere, and this is considered as a southern hemisphere. Are you getting? So we have learned about these two concepts. Then rotation. Rotation is nothing but the spinning of an Earth. The spinning of an Earth around a fixed axis. Around a fixed axis is called as a rotation. See, this is a globe. So it's spin around its own axis. Am I right? So this is called as a rotation. So because of the rotation, it causes day and night. What it causes because of rotation? It causes day and night. Are you getting? Now we have also discussed about revolution. What is my revolution? The Earth moves in a circular path. It moves in a circular path. So that is called as a revolution. And because of the revolution, the season, it takes the seasons there. Season changes takes place here. Season changes takes place. Now if you will see, there are the different seasons. Summer, winter, rainy. But rainy season does not causes in all the countries. According to the Hindu calendar, there are six seasons that we will see. But before that, we will see what is meant by the leap year. Most of the students might be knowing what is meant by the leap year. So leap year is nothing but after every 4 years, you can see in a calendar, there is one extra day is added, that is 29. The February is of 29 days. The February is of 29 days. Why does it happen? Why after 4 years, the February month, why we add a 1 day in a February month? Because if you will see, the Earth revolves around the sun. Yes, suppose this is the sun. Earth revolves around the sun. While revolving, it takes 365 days. Actual correction is, it takes 365 days and 6 hours. It takes how much time? 365 days and this 6 hours. And this 6 hours, if you will count, if after 4 years, means 6 fours are 24, 6 fours are 24, means it consists of 24 hours means it consists of one day. So the one day is added after 4 years. Are you getting this? And this year is called as a leap year. This year is called as a leap year. Are you getting that? Then according to the Hindu calendar, we have a 6 season. Let's see which are that. Spring, that is Vasanta Rutu. What it is called? Vasanta Rutu. It occurs mainly in March and April. Then Grishma Rutu, that is summer season. That now it is going on. It mainly occurs in May and mostly it covers June. Are you getting? Most of the days are taken off June. That is Grishma Rutu. That is called as a summer season. Now next is Varsha Rutu. That you know very well. Which season it is? Rainy season. Yes. It mainly takes place in July and August. It occurs mainly in July and August. Then last is Sharad Rutu. That is Autumn Rutu. It takes place in September and October. Then Hemant Rutu, that is pre-winter. You might be knowing about the pre-winter. Hemant Rutu, that mainly occurs during November and December. Then Shita Rutu, that is winter season. It mainly takes place during January, in month of January and February. So these are the 6 seasons takes place during the revolution of an earth. Vasanta, Grishma, Varsha, Sharad, Hemant, Shita. This Rutus takes place during according to the Hindu calendar. Are you getting this? Now during the revolution of an earth, now if you will see in a November month, now during the winter season, what happens? The sun rises later. And sets early. Means sometimes in this month, from this month, what we say that the nights are little bit longer. But after May month, what happens? The sun rises early and sets later. That time we can say the days are longer. Why does it happens? Because as you know, while the earth is rotating and revolving around the sun, its revolution is little bit tilted. And as it gets tilted, what happens when 6 months the northern hemisphere this part is near to the sun. So at that time here we got a longer days, and after 6 months the earth gets little bit tilted like this while during the revolution. So the northern hemisphere goes little bit backside, so here sun sets little bit early. Are you getting this? So sun sets little bit early. At that time we can say in the northern part here the sun sets little bit early. Are you getting? So here we can see there is a winter season and here we can say it is a summer season. Now when it is still like this, at that time here it is a summer and here is a winter. Are you getting? So only 2 seasons takes place in upper club, in northern and southern hemisphere. Are you getting? Then there are 2 days, that is 21st of March and 22nd of September. During these days, see if you will see, equal hours day. It consists of equal day and night. On which date? 21st March and 22nd of September. Keep in mind for the MCQ, for your final exam, they can ask which 2 days there in a year we get equal number of day and equal number of day and night. Then which are 2 days? 21st March and 22nd of September. 21st March and 22nd of September. Are you getting? Now, if you look at one more date, that is 21st June. On 21st June, we can say that is the longest day. It is a longest day. Why? 22nd of December, it is longest night. It is a longest night. What happens during the 21st of the June? The sun sets. The sun rises early and sets later. So this day is considered as a longest day. Longest day. While 22nd of December, it is considered as a longest night because sun rises later and sets early. So if this this day is called as a longest night. Are you getting this? I know little bit there is a to remember this day is little bit confusion, but you have to read this, you have to go through this. It is very important. Are you getting? In a class 4th book there is a lesson day and night state board book. I will send you the PDF of this lesson. The student, those who are not having the book, I will send the PDF of that lesson. You just go through it, read that lesson thoroughly. Are you getting? I hope you have understood it. Thank you.